Yeah, we were at slide 12. Thanks for joining back. Now, this is about criminal law and minor. Normally, under criminal law, a minor is not exempted and will be charged and put to trial in case of commission of an offense or for entering into illegal contracts, such as like contract for dealing with drugs or transportation of drugs and so on, except the minor is totally incapable of understanding the consequence of his or her action and has not been aware of such being misused for commission of an offense. Next is miscellaneous incapacities to contract. A contract with a lunatic is void ab initio. That is a person who is mentally deranged, or say, for example, is suffering from Alzheimer's or dementia. A person who has met with an accident and is medically incapable of giving consent for an emergency operation, then any close relative, parents, spouse, children, or friend present may provide consent as the next friend or a legal representative. Now, in Ireland, there is this Irish Assisted Decision-Making Capacity Act 2015, where under Section 8, they refer to the capacity of people with intellectual disabilities, such as extensive paralysis or delirious states from accidents or illnesses such as strokes, Alzheimer's disease, dementia, etc. Then in such a case, then legal guardian may be appointed by the court upon an appropriate application being filed and evidence about the condition of the applicant, and upon approval of the court, the legal guardian can take over the personal and proprietary affairs of such a person and contract on their behalf. Now, a person contracting within the influence of alcohol is voidable or void again, depending upon the jurisdiction. Example, in Australia, it is voidable. That is, when a person comes back to senses, a person can ratify a contract. Now, in the case Gibbons versus Wrights, the court held that a party may ratify a contract made while intoxicated after they cease to be intoxicated. Now, with reference to criminal law in miscellaneous aspects of being incapacitated, as per common law's McNaughton's rules, all persons suffering mental disability are exonerated or exempted from liability if they did not understand their actions and the subsequent consequence, which fact needs to be certified by an accredited medical authority, and the court must be convinced that it is safe to release the perpetrator into the community. So the court must be convinced that through a proper medical report saying that the person is actually mentally deranged and the act committed was not within he couldn't understand the consequence of his action. So therefore he can be exonerated and he may be released back into the community. So this is all. For this class. And next class, we will learn about, apart from capacity, we are going to now learn about